It has been described as one of the most remarkable UFO sightings in history. April 23, 2007. Captain Ray Bowyer was flying a routine passenger flight for a civilian airline company from Southampton on the coast of England to Alderney, a small island off the coast of France. A senior pilot for 18 years, the 45-minute flight is a route Captain Bowyer had flown thousands of times. Flight 544 departed at 2 p.m. with 9 passengers on board. Conditions were fine with good visibility for miles around. Captain Bowyer rose to an altitude of 4,000 feet or 1,200 metres and was cruising on autopilot about 16 kilometres or 10 miles south of the Isle of Wight. Captain Bowyer was doing paperwork and looking out for other aircraft when he noticed what appeared to be a brilliant yellow lamp or light. At first, he thought it might be an aeroplane or reflections from the ground or sun. But what he saw was no light reflection. He first spotted the object from a distance of 88 kilometres or 55 miles. For 15 minutes, the captain, as well as his passengers, witnessed the unidentified object. With his 10 times magnification binoculars, he could make out that it bore no relation to a normal aeroplane. He concluded that it was not a reflection, but an emission of light. With his binoculars, he could make out a definite shape. But as the plane flew closer, a second object came into view.
Both objects were of a flattened disc shape with a dark area to the right. They were brilliant yellow, with light emanating from within, and I estimated them to be up to possibly a mile across.
1 mile or 1.6 kilometres across. Simply put, they were enormous. But Ray wasn't the only one to spot the UFOs. His passengers did too.
We're travelling back from Southampton to Alderney in a Trilander. I had noticed Ray looking out through the windscreen with his binoculars, which is quite unusual.
I saw Ray turn around and talk to someone behind him while we were flying. Now, it wasn't worrying from the standpoint of flying, but it was unusual. And he was gesturing to something down below.
So the captain made contact with the Jersey Air Traffic Control to see if they could see anything on their radar.
The only indication I had on the radar was this solitary primary contact that seemed to be in the area that Ray was describing.
The UFOs were not stationary the whole time. As Ray's plane flew closer to the craft, they went from being laterally next to each other, one closer to Ray's plane than the other, to being lined up vertically with one directly above the other. As the distance shortened, Ray had a decision to make to protect his passengers.
This was a big object in the sky, very, very big object, and I didn't want to be too close to it. So it was at that time anyway where we had to descend to land, and with both objects still visible and to a lot of the passengers in the back of the aircraft, we descended through the 2,000 foot haze layer and lost sight of it.
As Bowyer was descending, he was alerted by air traffic control that he was not the only pilot to see the UFOs. Another plane, flying 40 kilometres in the opposite direction, had seen them too.
North-northeast towards Alderney, he could see an object matching the description that Ray had given. Once I'd heard the second pilot apparently confirm the sighting from an opposite direction, that's where it became really quite strange.
Bowyer reported the bizarre sighting as soon as he landed. It is one of the most immediate and thorough UFO reports ever filed, and includes drawings of what he says he saw that day. Captain Ray Bowyer is a serious pilot and a serious man, who says reporting his sighting was imperative. The thought of being dismissed or laughed at did not even cross his mind.
I did not feel that I was in any danger of being ridiculed, because all I did was report what actually happened, as was my duty as operating air crew.
The captain urged his peers to always report any unidentified object they see.
I would urge all fellow aircrew to report whatever they see as soon as possible and to stand up and be counted. It's only when crucial and critical witnesses such as aircrew make reports that the authorities will be kick-started into a broader investigation of this phenomena.
Through it all, Ray said he wasn't scared by what he saw.
Were you scared?
I wasn't too happy, put it that way. I was quite glad to get on the ground and have a cup of tea.
A wonderfully British end to one of the most remarkable UFO sightings in history.